Yes, welcome. Today we are starting a new topic known as transport system. Known as what? Transport system. We said in biology that we have four levels of life. Four levels, isn't it? Number one is the cell. Number one is the what? Cell. Number two is the tissue. Number two is the what? Tissue. Number three is the organ. Number three is the what? Organ. And number four is the what? System. Each of these units of life, or each of these stages of life, or each of these complexity in life can exist. You understand? You have some animals that are, and plants that are existing in cell level. Give me an example. Amoeba. You understand? They are existing in cell level. You understand? They will have some tissues in the body. Give me an example. There are tissues in the body, isn't it? The bone tissue and some other tissues in the body, isn't it? Then there are some what? Organs. What are the organs? Give me an example. When tissues come together, they form organs, you know. The organ for eye is what? The organ for seeing is what? So this is an organ, isn't it? This is another organ. What's this organ responsible for? How is this organ responsible for? Testing. Testing, isn't it? So these are organs. Now, when organs come together, you get what we call what? You get what we call what? System. And what are the systems in the body? Digestive system, transportation system, respiratory system. There are plenty of systems, isn't it? So today we are going to pick out one of those systems, and one of those systems is what? Transport system, transportation system. It's not like the transport that you drive from Abuja to Kano, is it? It's inside the body. How the blood is flowing. The blood is transporting, isn't it? It flows. When you took something on your skin, now you see blood coming out. That means that blood was flowing inside something that you now caught and you now start coming out, isn't it? So that is what we call transportation. So when the blood is transporting, it's carrying something. It's carrying maybe oxygen or food from one part of the body to the part that needs it. Is that clear? That is transport system. So by way of that, we'll now say that the movement of substances from one part of the body of an organism to the other part is termed what? Transportation. It stands what? Transportation. So that's what is transportation in biology. It's different from the transportation in real life, isn't it? Like driving from Kano to Enugu. This one is simply the word movement of what? Substances from one part of the body to the world another. Is that clear? Now, we say that materials such as carbon dioxide, what are those materials that move? What are those materials that move from one place of the body to the other? What are they? They are materials like what? Carbon dioxide, oxygen, nutrients, and digested what? Food. So these materials need to be what? Transported. Also, are waste products. You need to transport the waste, isn't it? From the body so that you can remove it from the body, isn't it? Also, are what? Waste products. Hormones, urea, salt, and what? Antibodies. All these things need to be transported. Is that clear? Now, an example will now ask you, what are the needs for transportation? Why would you want to transport? Number one, transportation is necessary in order to ensure that materials are carried from one part of the body to the what? To from where one part where they are produced or obtained to the part where they are what? Used or removed. Is that clear? If you have physics in your stomach, you need to take it down so that it will go out, is it not? Is it not? You have urea in your system. You need to get it to the bladder back so that it can do what? Go out. Then if you have oxygen here and your brain needs oxygen, you know that your brain needs oxygen. It has to be transported to your brain. If your brain is not getting enough oxygen, what will you do? You might faint and collapse, is it not? So you need oxygen. Then carbon dioxide needs to come out, is it not? It needs to be transported so that it will do what? Come out. So can you see those things that need to be transported? So you transport from where they are produced to where they are needed, is it not? So what are the other reasons why we transport? We mentioned one, isn't it? Number two is that small organisms with large surface area, right along. Small organisms with large surface area. So volume ratio employ simple process of diffusion. Is that clear? For the movement of materials in and out of them, for the movement of materials in out of them. Also, we have that in this number three, multicell. In multicellular organisms, diffusion is inadequate. Diffusion alone cannot do the work in multicellular organisms. Because of what? Because they possess a small body surface relative, to their large volume. This is because large quantities of nutrients and materials have to be transported over long distance within the body. So we now say that surface area to volume ratio dictates the type of transport that will take place in an organism. So those are important facts that you should know. That is why we have transport system. These reasons are why we have transport system. Number one, I've said you need to move materials from one point where they are produced to the point where they are what? Where they are needed or removed. Are we together on this? Good. So we say that the first need, the first reason why we do, why there has to be transportation in the body is that materials have to be moved from where they are produced to where they are needed, isn't it? Then secondly, small organisms, like, who can give me an example of a small organism? You know the one, who can tell me the one that looks like this? Which one looks like this? Para what? Paramecium, isn't it? which one looks like this. Which one? Uglina. You know the one they call Uglina?
Yes.
Which one looks more bad than the one where no gay shape, is it not?
Yes.
Good. So all these are called unicellular organisms. All of them are called what? Unicellular organism or small organism. They have one cell. They are existing in the cell level, isn't it? Isn't it? Human beings are existing in what? Multicellular. You understand? This one is only one cell. Human beings is the only one cell that is a human being. Human beings have plenty cells that form what? Tissue. Plenty tissue that form what? Organ. Plenty organ. It's not only one organ. We have organ that now form the what? System. And human beings still have plenty system that make up the human being. Is the only one system that we have? We have respiratory, transportation, and other system. Is that clear? Now, in this kind of animals, there is no need for transportation. Is that clear? There is no need for full-blown transportation. What they use is what we call, what they call what? Diffusion. You understand? Anything they need, you just fall on top of their body, and they're already using it. Because they have what we call large surface area to volume ratio. Is that clear? Their volume is very small, but their area is what? Big. You understand? But for us that are human beings, our volume is big compared to our surface area. So we need something that will not transport those things. You understand? So we need extensive transportation. Is that clear? So these small organisms, they don't need full-blown transportation system. You understand? They use just simple diffusion. If they need oxygen, oxygen that is in the sky will just fall on their body. It's already okay for them. Do they need veins and arteries to be transporting the blood? Do they need it? They don't need it because their body is open there. So that's why we say small organisms with large surface area to volume ratio employ simple processes of what? Diffusion for the movement of materials in and out of them. Is that clear? Now, multicellular organism like us, you understand? Diffusion is what? Inadequate. Inadequate simply means it's not enough. Is that clear? Diffusion is inadequate because they possess small body surface relative to their what? Large what? Value. Is that clear? Now, the last fact says that surface area to volume ratio dictates the type of what? Transport that will take place in organism. Is that clear? Surface area to the volume ratio, that's what it means. So, for an organism that is having very high surface area to volume ratio, what type of way will it spread this material? The one that has high surface to volume ratio, it will use what? Diffusion. The one that has very small surface to volume ratio, we use what? We use what? Transport system. Is that clear? So now we are going to look at advantages of transportation. Advantages of transportation. What are the advantages of the transport system? What are the advantages of the transport system in the body? Number one, it helps in the supply of materials for cell metabolism. It helps in the supply of materials for cell metabolism. That's the number one. That's the number one advantage. Number two, waste products are removed. Number two is that waste products are removed. You understand? In transportation, you can easily remove what? Waste products. Now, what are the materials that are used that are transported? Materials for transportation. So, then we'll ask you, which of the following materials is not transported in organisms? So you need to know this material. So this material include number one, oxygen. I've mentioned these materials before, isn't it? You need to know all these materials because they will tell you which of the following materials is not transported. You need to know the ones that are transported. Oxygen, amino acid, glucose, fatty acid, and glycerol. Carbon dioxide, nitrogenous waste, water, hormones, vitamins, antioxidants, and inorganic salts. So these are the material that you transport. Is that clear? Now, media of transportation. What do you use in doing this transportation? Media of what? Transportation. What are the things that carry these things to travel? We note that materials are always transported in liquid form. Is that clear? Every transport you have to do has to be in liquid form or in liquid media. So what is this liquid media that transports? Unicellular organisms do so through protoplasm, plants through cell sap, higher animals through blood and lymphatic systems. So, media of transportation, we say that materials are always transported in liquid what? Media. So how is this liquid media? Who and who does what for what? Now, we note that unicellular organisms, what is their transport media? What carries all these things for them that we mentioned? Their oxygen, their amino acid. What carries them? What carries them is their what we call protoplasm. That's their transport media. Plants. What transports for plants? Cell what? Cell sap. That's what does transport for plants. Higher animals like human beings. Do you know what transports for them?
Blood.
That's what you use in transporting your oxygen. Blood and what we call, some of them use what we call lymphatic system. Is that clear? So better you know that. So please, on top of this, write organism. Are you seeing this? Then what? Here will be what? Media for what? Transport. So you now know. Temp is going to ask you, what is the media of transport for plants? What will be the answer? They will write blood, they will have lymphatic cells and all those things. You should know that you should pick what cells are. What is the transport media for unicellular organisms like euglena and all the rest of them?
Protoplasm.
What is the transport system for animals, higher animals?
Blood and lymphatic system, is that clear?
So what are those things that are being transported? Oxygen, good. Carbon dioxide and the rest of it.